Hello and welcome back to Sheaf Math. In today's lesson, you're going to be able to determine whether an xy point satisfies a linear equation. In other words, is it a solution to that equation? Now let's do a little recap of linear equations. A linear equation is an equation that has an x and a y in it. And why do we use the x and the y so much? Well, we use this because we have an xy coordinate plane, and this equation forms a straight line, and that's why it's called linear. It's a form of line. Now, that line right there is made up of an infinite number of points, and every point on there, and every point between the point, and every point between those points, which is infinite numbers of points, is a solution, okay? And the solution we name by using xy, a coordinate pair. We use its x and its y coordinates, and we also call it an ordered pair. Now the question that you will be asked is, does negative 2, 1 satisfy the linear equation? Now this the point could be anything here, so we have to see if negative 2, 1 is actually on that line. And so negative 2, 1 is right there, and it definitely is. So this is a solution, so it does satisfy the linear equation. The answer is yes. But a graph is really not necessary because it does take a while to make a graph, and you can actually do it very quickly algebraically. So here's another example, y equals 3x plus 5. And the question is, does 2, 11 satisfy the linear equation? So what we're gonna do, our 2 is the x and the 11 is the y. We're gonna put 2 in for x and 11 in for y, just like this. And we're gonna simplify and see if the left side equals the right side. If it works, then it does satisfy the linear equation. So 3 times 2 is 6, and 6 plus 5 is definitely 11. Therefore, the answer is yes, it does satisfy that linear equation. It is one of the points on the line. Here's a few more examples. So y equals 7x minus 3. Does 4, 16 satisfy this? So we're going to put 4 in for x, 16 in for y, and simplify. So 28 minus 3 on the right makes 25, and that does not equal. So the answer is no. 416 is not a solution. It's not on the line. How about y equals 6x? A very common type of equation. And does 2, 12 satisfy this? So I put 2 in for x, 12 in for y, and I simplify, and sure enough, 12 equals 12. So 2, 12 does work. It satisfies the equation. It is a solution. The answer is yes. So you'll get all sorts of equations, negatives, decimals, fractions, all those things, and you're just going to have to work them out. Hopefully you have all those skills down. So does 4, 10 satisfy this equation? Let's see. I put 4 in for x, 10 in for y, and I get negative 8 plus 18, and sure enough, 10 equals 10. So the answer is yes, 410 is a solution and satisfies the linear equation. And then we have some equations with big numbers in them. And so this is just a matter of working it out using a calculator if you have to. We'll put negative 2 in for x, 12 in for y, and simplify. So negative 80 plus 68 is negative 12, and so 12 does not equal negative 12. These are ones that are trying to trick you, so make sure that you catch that, and the answer would be no. All right, I hope you learned a little bit about whether a xy is a solution to a linear equation. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.